guys. Hope you guys had a good Thanksgiving. I'm going to show you how we cooked our turkey for Thanksgiving, and we'll probably do the same thing around Christmas time. You want to get softened butter. You got 4 sticks. Got like 4 cloves of garlic. I got a couple lemons here. And the lemon juices. You want to go ahead and save these. We'll use them again later. Okay, now you want to put a little bit of olive oil in it. This prevents the butter from burning. Some parsley flakes. Use fresh parsley if you have it on hand. Some pepper. And some salt. This is pink Himalayan salt. Okay, just go ahead and blend all this together. It's going to be messy. Yeah, I've got the turkey inside the roaster pan on top of a rack. And now I'm going to loosen the skin on top of the breast, and we're going to shove this butter mixture underneath the skin on top of the breast, and that'll keep the breast meat moist. See, just loosen up all that skin. Go ahead. Grab a ball of that butter mixture. Any extra mixture you got, you just go ahead and spread around on the outside. Okay, now I'm going to stuff the turkey with some leftover lemons, some of our onions here from our garden, and some bay leaves. take this over to the roaster. Okay, we're going to cook this at 325 degrees, and about midway point, we're going to do something else to it, and I'll come back when we reach that point. This will probably take about 4.5 hours or so, based on the size of the turkey. It's about a 15-pound turkey. Anyway, I'll come back to you when we get to the midway point, and I'll show you what else I'm going to do. Okay, guys, now about the midway point. Help to lock in more moisture in the breast meat. I'm going ahead and cover it up with some bacon. Pop that lid back on and we'll cook it the rest of the way. Should be about, I guess, another couple more hours. Yeah. All right, I brought in some sweet potatoes that we had out in the garden. I'm gonna get these peeled and cube them and put them in here and steam them. Okay, we'll let that steam cook for a while and then I'll show you the next step I'm going to do with these. All right, our turkey's done. It reads 180. You want it to be 165, so looks like it may have got a little overcooked, but we'll see. Anyways, I'm going to take the bacon off and continue frying the bacon in the frying pan, and we'll use that as part of the gravy. It should have crisped up in here. I might have waited too long before I put it in, but well, it's a learning curve. Okay, well, I got the bacon on the pan on there frying up to get it crispy. I'm gonna go ahead and take out the innards, the stuffing I put in there, the onions, the lime, lemon. Okay, I'm gonna chop up the bacon. Put that back in the pan. Go ahead and put in the onions and lemons that we had stuck inside the turkey. Put that all in the pan. Now I'm going to add a little bit of apple cider vinegar. I'll let that cook down. Put all the juices in there from the turkey. pepper. And some pink Himalayan salt. Over in this far pan here, I'm going to melt some butter. This here is just plain red Pontiac potatoes from our garden. Now we're going to add some brown sugar to that butter.
One more spoonful.
Okay, now we're going to add our sweet potatoes. These are the ones we grew in our garden this year. I know it looks a little on the white side. I'm used to them being kind of orange, so I'm not sure what variety of sweet potato that one there is. Getting a little coated. Okay, now we're gonna go ahead and drain this. Save all the gravy and keep. Alright, put it back on the heat. Okay, I'm going to add a little bit of cornstarch to it to thicken it up. I got some of the gravy in here. Just two heaping spoonfuls of cornstarch. Mix that up. So I'll dissolve all that cornstarch. Back to a boil. Meanwhile, here's our sweet potatoes. There you go. There's our Thanksgiving dinner. Got some rolls, sweet potatoes from the garden, with some butter and brown sugar, red Pontiac potatoes covered with gravy made from our turkey juices. And here's our turkey. It's kind of like a lemon
flavored turkey. Well, anyhow, thanks for stopping by and seeing how I cook my Thanksgiving dinner this year. Around Christmas time, we'll probably do the same thing. Maybe change it up a little bit and try something new. We'll catch you on that one.